Welcome. Let's start. Probably still some people downstairs, but they'll catch on down the road. This is the general introduction to Wikidata, especially targeted at GLAMs, of course also for other people. My name is Maarten Dammers. I'm known on the projects as user Multichill. I've been around on Wikipedia and on Commons and Wikidata for quite some time, about 6 years. Been involved with GlamWiki things, with bots, with Wikilos monuments, did a couple of uploads to Commons and all sorts of things. Back to ancient history, how did Wikidata start? Back in the day, it sounds very a long time ago, but actually only 3 years ago, every Wikipedia version would link articles to the other language versions on other Wikipedia. So for example, if you have the article about The Hague on the English Wikipedia and the article on the Dutch Wikipedia over about Den Haag, there would be a link somewhere hidden on the bottom to the other language versions. And if someone would write an article about The Hague in, for example, some, I don't know, Chinese, a robot would come along and had to propagate all these links to all the language versions. That didn't scale very well, and we're looking for a solution to make it more centralized. So more like having all the Wikipedias and keeping that information on one point. That's how Wikidata started back in the day, to just centralize all these links into one location. And the first item which was created was, of course, the universe. It was somewhere in October 2012. The universe was created on Wikidata. Actually, Q2 is Earth. So I'm not sure what Q3 is. Sorry?
It's a big
German. Yeah, it's
also not NPOV.
Yeah. I think the first 20 items were just hard-coded, just a bit of a joke. I'm not sure what 42 is, but you should look it up. So the universe was created, Wikidata was created as a new project in the Wikimedia family. It was already mentioned in the general introduction that Wikimedia has a lot of different projects. You have, of course, Wikipedia, everyone knows Wikipedia, but also Wikimedia Commons, lesser known Wikivoyage or Wikibooks. Wikidata is one of the newer projects in that family. All the wiki thing is always really confusing. The software powering all our sites is called MediaWiki, and the extension powering Wikidata is called Wikibase. If you're lost, that's no problem. We always mess it up ourselves too. Wikidata has a concept of an item. An item is a piece of information that has several parts. At the top, you'll see a label, in this case, Johannes Vermeer. You have a description. As you can see, all of them are in multiple languages. So this is actually my settings. These are the languages I want to see on Wikidata, but you can configure that for yourself. For example, Hebrew or Greek or some other language, you can configure that. And you can add aliases, especially when it comes to old painters. You get huge lists of aliases because we always mess up the spelling or change it over time. For Johannes Vermeer, it's actually not that many, but I think it's complete. Incomplete. You might see Jan Vermeer van Delft or something like that. So label, description, aliases, and everything is multilingual. On Wikipedia, we have the problem that if we have two things that have the same name, we have to disambiguate that. So we give it, for example, in the US, we have lots of towns or cities that all have the same name. So we say someplace in Alabama or someplace in Alaska. On Wikidata, we don't disambiguate in the label, we do that in the description. So we just say someplace, and in the description, we say where it is or what it is to make the difference between the different items. Every item has a unique number. That's the Q number you see at the top. It just goes up. We're at, I don't know, 18 million right now. So every time we create a new item, a new Q number gets added. And there's lots of space in between. Sometimes Q numbers get used, but not actually created. The first step was, of course, to import everything from Wikipedia to have the centralized language links. So you'll notice that the lower the queue numbers, the more links to Wikipedias you have, because those are at the bottom. For example, for Johannes Vermeer, the codes are is the language code, and then you see the article name in the language. It actually goes on much longer, but if I would have put more on it, you couldn't have read it. So, for example, we can still see the English Johannes Vermeer, or apparently some German dialect calls it Jan Vermeer. And these tiny little things here are called badges. So if an article is really good in some language Wikipedia, you can add a badge to it. Like it's a featured article or a good article, or different Wikipedias have different systems to handle that. Oh, if you have any questions, please just interrupt me, ask questions. We have plenty of time to explain things.
Are the interlanguage links updated all the time?
So you added the link interlanguage links on Wikidata, and the software automatically shows it on the connected articles. So the connected articles, there's a job in the background that says, hey, this article has to be updated. And so by the time someone looks at the article, you'll see the new list. It's all hidden in the software.
But yes, it is also.
Yeah, you have to seed it. So, for example, you would start a new article about The Hague. You would have to go to Wikidata and add the link. If the software can't automatically find it.
You can do that right with Wikipedia now. You can bring you over to Wikidata. When you create a new article on the left panel, there's a couple of little buttons. It's super easy.
Yeah. It just asks you, do you know this article in another language? You put it in and it will automatically link everything together.
Once it's linked, the software does track it. So for example, if one of those languages realized that it's been calling Vermeer the wrong name, you know, you wanted to change it on their local Wikipedia, they could move the page, which is how we rename things on Wikipedia, and it will, all the other wikis that are linking to it will link to the new page automatically.
Actually, in the software, you'll see on Wikidata that if you link move a page on some Wikipedia, on Wikidata you see, oh, that you moved the page, and oh, I updated the link. So it's all happening automatically these days.
As long as you have the redirection.
No, actually, the move action triggers the update of Wikidata. So it's pretty recent. Up until a couple months ago, you had to manually do some stuff, but now it seems to be all worked out. We also have properties. So items are with Q, properties are with P. For example, place of birth, quite useful for people. It has the same structure as an item, so you still have the label, the description, and possible aliases. Especially for date of birth, you have all these abbreviations, and of course, you have it in multiple languages, because everything is multilingual. There's no such thing as monolingual on Wikidata.
This is, for example, the content of an item.
I'll get
could
to that.
I mean, could be.
For example, this is how we use place of birth. This is from the Vermeer item. On Vermeer, we have a statement, or actually a claim, saying place of birth is Delft. Delft is a city not that far from here. So you can use these properties on an item to create claims linking it to other items or other values. For example, date of birth would probably be a date or a time value instead of a link to another item. We have all sorts of items. For example, you can put in an image or a coordinate. And we still lack a number of items. For example, we don't have units yet. So you can't say for a painting, the painting is 1 meter wide, because we don't have that concept yet. It still needs to be implemented.
When are units coming?
I don't know. I hope sooner than later, but there's probably a bug somewhere hidden on a roadmap, I don't know. It's one of those things that's yeah, people try to work around it, but we don't have units yet, so we can't express a lot of things. We have like strings or numbers, so something like a population, you can say the population is some number, but you can't say that person's height is this, because we don't have units. That's still.
Wikipedia can sort the units.
No, we just haven't implemented it yet. We're getting to that. So we have two things, a claim and a statement, and they're very close to each other. And they're always confusing. A statement is the part like this, some property and some value. A claim is that. A statement is the whole package. So what you can do is, you, for example, with inventory number SKA2344. No people from the Rijksmuseum here to... she'll probably know what painting this is. I took a famous one. And we have the concept of qualifiers. So there's maybe another collection out there that has the same inventory number. So we use a qualifier to tell, okay, this is only valid in the collection of the Rijksmuseum. That way you can avoid collisions. Say you have two museums, both started their collection management system and both started with one and then two. We need some way to distinguish between values. So qualifiers...
Change. Sorry? Some qualifier changes. Is there some concept of persistence? Because these management systems don't always deliver the same... not every museum has these qualifiers, and they use just the export from their system, and they change sometimes from export to export.
We try to use the inventory numbers. That's up to the users to use. And I'm pretty sure these are. I will stick around for a while. But we also use the handles if it comes to the Rijksmuseum. And of course, we can always qualify them valid until 2015, because that's also a qualifier. That's a big concept difference between Wikipedia and Wikidata. And Wikidata, it models data that was valid at some point. So if you have an info box on Wikipedia saying the current president for the United States is Barack Obama, and he leaves office at some point, you would just update that info box and throw away the data that's in there. On Wikidata, you would keep the fact that he was president at some point, but just qualify it and say, okay, that was valid until some Americans in here probably know when he leaves office. Somewhere, I don't know, 2016, I guess. And you would just add another president saying, oh, that he started or she started in 2016. So qualifiers make it more flexible. And of course, we love references. There's no such thing as the truth. There's only references and sources. So we try to support every statement we make with a reference, and preferably for web links when we retrieve it.
Martin, a question. If you have sort of competing claims, let's say that it was in question whether Vermeer was born in Delft or in Maastricht, could you represent that?
Yeah, you could use qualifiers. For example, we have a qualifier like disputed by. There's also, I didn't include it because you can include ranks. So you can say this statement is preferred or normal or deprecated. So you can, in software, technically you can model it, but it's sometimes quite hard how to model these kind of things, and it seems to work well with qualifiers, because then you can say this was supported by or disputed by someone. Especially when you take, for example, old paintings, who made the painting? You can go through times with, oh, in that century they thought it was Vermeer, in that century they thought it was some of his students, and then they thought it was Vermeer again. You could probably model that, but it takes quite a bit of effort to do that.
To follow up on that, to be clear, you could have two place of birth entries for that entity. Yeah. You could literally have both Delft and Maastricht,
each with its own reference.
Yeah, you can have multiple. So for date of birth, we have many people with multiple date of birth claims, because we're not sure. Like one source says one date and one source says another date. We just put in both with the source, and yeah, people have to figure out which one is true.
I mean, it's not a problem as long as we have sources.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's actually this painting. And I tried to take one that was not yellowish. So the statement, this statement is actually on the yellow milkmaid painting. I'm just there. this is the from the documentation. There's also a link to the glossary. This explains all the concepts we have on Wikidata. So you see, again, you have the property, you have the value, and maybe some qualifiers. That is a claim. And when you add a reference to it, it becomes a statement. And but these seems to be used interchangeably. What kind of things can we do it with these claims? We have the info boxes on the Wikipedia, these boxes you see on the right. Slowly, Wikipedias are using this data on Wikidata to fill these info boxes. English Wikipedia is quite conservative, so I'm pretty sure they only do it for one or two templates. The Russian Wikipedia seems to be way ahead of everyone else and has these whole info boxes grabbing from Wikidata. But technically, if you have these boxes on Wikipedia articles, these things can be fetched from Wikidata. So instead of having to edit these really difficult templates, you just have to put on an empty template and it will grab all the statements from Wikidata and fill the whole box. So you don't have to do it twice.
That means everyone can do it.
Yeah, everyone can do it.
Not just Wikipedia?
No, everyone who can push on the edit button could do that. But we're not there yet. It's what I said before, only the Russian Wikipedia seems to be way ahead of us. And I don't see a lot of people in this room who actually manage Russian. Maybe one if Beat is out too. Oh, we have some people here. So it's not used a lot yet, but it will be, it will be.
If I see a mistake on this read-only data, on Wikidata.
It's not read-only, you can edit it.
So there's a button where I can jump directly and tell it that direct?
Yeah, so you can edit, but...
I mean, if I see it on a template, and the date is wrong.
No, that's one of the things that still has to... be worked out what's the easiest way, because it's of course very confusing for a user if you see a box with all sorts of information and you press edit and like, where did that information come from? So from a user perspective, there should be more integration between that kind of templates and the actual data backend.
This is also, sorry, very important for small Wikipedias like the Bulgarian.
Yeah.
Very small community, because we just cannot afford to be entering populations of German cities and coordinates.
Yeah. Especially, so the bigger Wikipedias are more conservative because they already have all of that. For the smaller, it's of course much easier already. All the data is on Wikidata, and you just create an article and you can focus on writing it, especially now with the translation extension piloting. So you can translate articles between languages. It makes it really much easier to make articles in your language.
I'd like to flesh out what you were saying for the non-Wikipedians in the audience to make clear the value of this population thing. If you write an article about a German city in a smaller language, like Arabic, spoken by many more people than German, but it's a smaller wiki, right? It's a smaller community. If you translate that article about that German city and you copy the current population count from the English article or German article, or the town hall site of that German city, you have the correct data in Arabic. 3 years go by, or 10 years go by, there is another census in Germany, there is an updated population figure. That updated population figure will quickly be updated in German by Germans, presumably. What is the likelihood of you as an Arabic Wikipedian noticing the German census and updating it in your article? The fact is, for the vast majority of cases, the population size, the name of the current mayor or minister or whatever about other countries, other cultures, remains stale in those smaller Wikipedias and is not updated. Now, if we took that name from Wikidata, the moment some Wikipedian anywhere in the world has access to fresher information, that fresh information will be displayed on everybody's home wiki in their own language. The labels would also be correct.
But doesn't this concept clash with your there's no troops, there's no authority approach? What if somebody claims there's another figure valid and cites a source for?
So you can have multiple values and you have ways of saying I prefer that value.
Yeah, but it's still the decision the user has to make.
Exactly, but that's the same with now with writing.
We have a default.
So you know, with respect to this specific case, if someone was to come along and you know change the date on Wikidata,
but you don't change it. You add a date if it's disputed.
Okay, but what if they delete the previous date and add a new date? Would the people watching, you know, all the articles and all the languages that pertain that have that bit of information, does it appear on their watch list?
Yes. If you have the old school watch list, the one that gives you a huge feed, you'll see all the Wikidata items. The new one that most people are using, not, but they're fixing that. You have the collapsed watch list, that you see all the edits of an article grouped together. That one won't see show Wikidata edits. The old one that just gives you a really long feed of all the edits on things you're watching, that one will show Wikidata, but they're still fixing it. Because vandalism or these kind of things, change are of course important. Go ahead.
Does this mean that we need to shift from the idea of the infobox containing stuff that's in the article to the infobox containing stuff that's not in the article? Because, so if you have the name of the mayor, for example, because otherwise you have a situation where the infobox has been updated, the article hasn't, and they contradict each other. Now, if you can set it so that those data rights are themselves fed into the text, you can. Then
technically, everything is possible, but you, as a Wikipedia community, you have to decide on how to do it. Because you don't want to have template thingies in full text. That's confusing. You might want to have it in the in the running text. I don't know. It's up to the Wikipedia community to decide on that.
It seems like it was, you know, in the long run, why not? Because if you're going to talk about changing data in one place and having 267 languages not needing to change it, then you know, why not have it everywhere?
Wikidata just offers the possibility. If you want to use it, it's up to the local language projects to decide. So what kind of stuff do we have in Wikidata? We have about 13 million items right now. So 13 million concepts, if you would call it. We have 2.8 million humans. For example, Albert Einstein, and most of these humans are men. About 2.2 million items we have are about men. So that's a really large part of the items about humans are men. And of those, about 240,000, so a bit over 10%, are politicians. I do have to say that I looked at the data. It appears that like if you were a count back in the day or a king, you're labeled as politician. Because in fact, you were, of course, a politician, but not the kind of politician we would say these days. So it might be a bit skewed, the data. And we have people from all times. Among them, we have about 50,000 items about painters. I didn't expect them to be that that high. So for example, also, of course, about Rembrandt. And we also have items about women, only about 400,000. And yeah, do you know who this is? Yes, of course, you. We also have a lot of items about taxonomy, or actually about species or genuses. About 1.9 million items. That's a lot of flowers, a lot of flowers, and lots of, yeah, now butterflies are also up very high, so if you like butterflies, you're in the right place. And yes, beetles. Lots and lots of beetles, because there's a lot of species of beetles. And you would wonder, why do we have so much items about these kind of things? That's because of these guys, bots. We, on several language Wikipedias, a lot of people imported articles or bots created articles about species. The Dutch Wikipedia did a lot of that, the Swedish Wikipedia. And of course, if something has an article on Wikipedia, Wikidata gets an item. So in the end, we have lots of items about species. So that's an interesting thing to note. We also have a lot of items about locations from the biggest cities, for example, here in Hong Kong, from Victoria's Peak. I think several people here went there a couple years ago with Wikimania, to the smallest towns you can imagine. Okay, Stroopwafel for who says? This is Bodhi in the high desert in California.
Silver City?
No.
Oh, it looks like Silver City.
No, it's Bodhi in the high desert in California. It's blistering hot in the summer and very cold in winter. Of course, we have a lot of items about locations already on Wikipedia. So we end up with a lot of items about that on Wikidata too. We have a lot of historic buildings. There's a lot of people writing about them. And we did some imports, more about that later. So if you look at cultural perspective, we also have quite a few paintings. And we're quite fast. I think we already have an item about this painting, but I can't link to the Rijksmuseum website yet because they have to add it to their system. They bought this at the art fair a couple of months ago, the TEFAF, I think it's called, in Maastricht. And it's a painting by Jan Asselijn. It's a breach of the dike somewhere near Amsterdam. And quite a few painters made paintings or sketches of this event. And a breach. So you don't want to have this. We don't like that. It's gets your feet wet. It will always happen, but anyway, so we have quite a few items about paintings. And of course, we also have paintings of historic buildings. For example, if we have an item about this painting, and it will say it depicts several historic buildings, because that one is a Rijksmonument, of course, and that one, and that one, and most of the buildings here. This is the main square in Haarlem by Berkenheide, in Berkenheide. Wikidata is relatively young. We only celebrated the second birthday last October. It started in October 2012. So it's a brand new project, and it's already doing so much. It's being developed by Wikimedia Germany. This is the Wikidata team, and they like paintings too, so they're with Glammy. The project lead is Lydia in the middle, and the people working on Wikidata, a lot of them are long-time Wikipedians or long-time software developers, or also active in Semantic Media Wiki. That's the semantic variant which has similar functionality to Wikidata, but didn't scale that well, so they started from scratch with all the lessons learned from that project. And they do the technical development. So they all the new features, bug fixes, all the cool stuff, they're working on it. And of course, together with the Wikimedia Foundation, because they actually host the site. And they're based out of Berlin, because there's their main office. And Wikidata is still work in progress. It's I already mentioned the units, the missing units. There's still plenty of things that haven't been implemented yet. And,
ranking.
Yeah, ranking is also a possibility or problem. And there's many things that are missing. But people are actively adding things. So it's like building a boat while in high sea. And it seems to work pretty well. It didn't sink, or at least not that often. Yeah, I'm not sure yet. I found this one on Commons. I thought it was it was a nice picture to use. So one of the main things missing is units. We have the concept of random access or arbitrary access. So now I showed you the info box that you can exit or use the data on the connected item. Now you can only use the data on the directly connected item, not from another item. So, for example, if you have an item about the KB and you would want to use claims from the Hague item, that's not possible right now. That still has to be implemented. There's also, we don't have queries yet, so you can't. There is a query engine, but that's user supported, that's actually built on top of it on a separate environment. It has to be in core, so you can make queries on the data, say, give me all the people who were born in 1900 and 1901 in, I don't know, Haarlem, and it would return you a list. That's not there yet. Wikidata is very young. So if Wikipedia feels sometimes a bit more like this, like the UN, like people are all talking, big debates, and lots of things going on, this is more like Wikidata. We're in the middle of the desert, and it's sometimes more of a Wild West atmosphere. A lot of ground still has to be covered. There are rules, but not a lot of rules, and they're pretty pragmatic. There's not a lot of politics. It's a pretty friendly atmosphere out there. And we're exploring new ground, a lot of things we haven't done before. Do remember that Wikipedia is already over 12 years old, and Wikidata only 2 years old, so it had a bit more time to develop. Of course, yeah.
There's a new, or there's an older site that can be merged into Wikidata. Freebase, yeah.
Yeah, but it's not really about the site, it's about the community running the site.
Yeah.
And of course, a lot of people who were active on Wikidata have been active on Wikipedia before, but also quite a few people who haven't been active on our projects started to edit on Wikidata. So yeah, it's a new community, and it's quite friendly. One of the things is really in work in progress is the notability. What's notable? What should we create an item about? We don't want to become some sort of data dump where everyone just dumps their data and drives home again. Where's on Wikipedia you have to...
It still happens.
It still happens, but like for example, you have on Wikipedia you have the debate between the deletionists, people who say I prefer deletion when unsure, and the inclusionists who say let's keep it. Similar debates we have on Wikidata. But the level of notability is, it still has to be established. What kind of data do we want? Do we want to have every writer that ever lived? And it might include me because I wrote a poem at school and I submitted it somewhere. Where do we, and we don't know yet, and that still has to be established, and that's a constant process. One of the main things is that if you put data on Wikidata, it should be used and maintained. That's my personal opinion, but if data isn't used, it becomes stale. And if it's used, people will see mistakes and they will update it. And otherwise, it will just sit in the corner and slowly rot away, or nothing will happen with it. One of the things, projects I ran before this was Wikilost Monuments. You might have heard of it. It was, the goal of the project was to get photos of historic buildings. And for that, we developed a database which contains historic buildings. It contains about 1.3 million records at the moment. It's still updating. Every day it will go over Wikipedia, grab all the data, and make a database out of it. We have several wiki projects on Wikidata, and one of them is to get this data of historic buildings onto Wikidata as items. So instead of sitting somewhere in a database, somewhere on some lab environment, that it's part of Wikidata. We did an import of all the Rijksmonumenten here in the Netherlands. Those are historic buildings here in the Netherlands. And also some other countries are quite complete, like in Switzerland we did some imports. And I'm pretty sure the US, almost every historic site there has an article by now, so it will have a Wikidata item. So and that's a good way of making that more accessible. One of the other things happening a lot on Wikidata that's is work in progress is authority control, or vocabularies. These are the four vocabularies offered by the Getty right now. The art and architecture thesaurus that describes concepts, like what's a painting, what's a, I don't know, what's a rosary, what's a church. The geographic name one is more about locations, or actually more about the names of locations. We're here in, I would call it Den Haag of Schravenhagen. You would maybe call it The Hague. It's all the same place. How do you make records of that so you know you're referring to the same place? especially like all these Dutch cities, their name changed over time. So you would have tens of variations of the name. They have a thesaurus for that. The union list of artist names is all about creators, mostly painters, but also sculptors. So you would find Rembrandt or Michelangelo or name your favorite painter, you probably find it in there. And CONA, the Cultural Objects Name Authorities, I think it's a relatively new one, but it was relatively new for me. It's about objects. So for example, the Nachtwacht is in there, and it's still relatively small. On Wikidata, we link to all these kind of vocabularies or thesaurus, or authority control, whatever you would like to call it. So on a Wikidata item, we can make a direct link to one of these databases. For example, this is FIAF. Who knows what FIAF is or doesn't know? No, next one doesn't know? No, I saw lots of hands going for doesn't know. But Wikidata has about 500,000 links to FIAF right now. FIAF goes back a bit longer than Wikidata because on Wikipedia, people already added links to FIAF. So by the time Wikidata came around, it was imported to Wikidata and all scraped from all the different languages. And recently, FIAF announced they're actually going to link to Wikidata too, besides the Wikipedias. So it will be really closely connected. So this is what the cloud they have. It's these all represent some local institution. For example, we're in National Archives or the Royal Library. They're one of those flags, and that they're all interconnected. Wikidata will become one of those links in there at some point.
It's already done.
Is it?
Yeah. Thanks to the Swiss.
Ah, that's new. I didn't see that one. Oh, so they actually implemented it already. That's even better. I didn't know that. I saw the press release. I think it was two or three. So it's about.
Is it a kind of reference?
Yeah. So here in the Royal Library, you have a record about a name. I don't know. Let's say what kind of Rembrandt, for example.
So you had Vermeer up there, right?
Yeah, Vermeer, for example. Vermeer has a unique ID in this library, but the Swiss Library also has a record about Vermeer. And this is all about connecting these records that we know we are talking about the same person. So instead of just having your local vocabulary, you know that your vocabulary is actually, some items are the same as in an external vocabulary. So you can link them all together. And one thing you notice when you started linking this, you'll find lots of mistakes. Because more people looked at it, the more people you interconnect, you notice that, for example, brothers who had similar names, or you see it a lot with painters that you have the younger and the older that are all completely mixed up. And so the more links you have, the better it's the data probably is. I think, I'm not sure, this one might be for Einstein, I'm not sure where. This one is from Rembrandt. So Rembrandt has quite a few entries already.
So VF is an aggregation of individual authority files maintained by libraries and archives that have their own canonical standard ways to refer to certain people, and then, as Martin said, connecting them. My ID 7 is your ID 14 and your ID 21, all the same person, but not ID 36, which is the same name, but different person, right? So it's an aggregation of those authority files, and VF stands for Virtual International Authority File.
Right. Tomorrow there's also a presentation by the Europeana people, and they will also go into the authority control quite a bit. That's might be interesting also to go.
Just a curiosity, yeah. Is if you look at the Communist Party of Zhugao, Russia,
you have three
items. It had five VF IDs, yeah. In Wikidata. They deleted them, but still it has five Library of Congress IDs. The reason is that the library people refer to these organizations in slightly different ways. So if you look at it in VF, one of the IDs is the propaganda department of the party. It's a different organization. And the other three are of the 12th Congress of the party, because the 12th Congress produced proceedings. So conferences also take unique numbers in India. But somebody in Wikidata said, that's the Communist Party. That's the same as that. It's all the Communist Party. No, it's not.
But that's proper modeling. So I imported all the Rijksmonumenten, and sometimes you have two houses that are one Rijksmonument. Or there are two Rijksmonumenten, but the article is about the combined block. So you have to model that. We call it the Bonnie and Clyde problem, because you have Bonnie and Clyde. Some Wikipedias have one article about both of them, and others have an article about Bonnie and an article about Clyde. And that's one of the...
Some have some about Bonnie and Clyde too.
Yeah, so that's one of the modeling things, problems we have, like how to divide things or merge them together. And you always end up with three items. So one for Bonnie, one for Clyde, and one for them together. And you link them all together. Yeah.
Also in the DMV, the German authority file, you have undistinguished names. So yeah. Like, for example, Kran, but we don't know whether that was the younger or the older. So about one painting, there's some doubt who did it.
Yeah.
And it's very wrong to go and co-reference these to either this product or that product in the Wikidata, or even to the disambiguation page. We should be co-referencing known entities, not disambiguation pages.
Yeah.
Just for my understanding, means that somewhere there's a database and we are referencing to this database. Or is Wikidata, in the very end, the reference database for altogether?
Well, Wikidata itself is no reference because it's only secondary sources. It's an aggregation.
Okay, it's in this case, I find the metadata,
yeah.
but is VF, is, where is this? Who is the owner of this?
OCLC, the library organization.
Okay.
OCLC maintains that. And yeah, you have to waive. Oh, I think there's someone from OCLC here too this weekend, but I'm not sure.
Tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway. I think it's really hard to predict what is going to happen again, because it's a matter of cooperation. But right now, VR has 33 million people, and Wikidata has 12.5. VR is going to suck up a million from Wikidata. Now, then it is a question of this notability, whether at one point Wikidata wants to get all of the VR.
In my personal opinion, I think Wikidata will always stay a bit of a subset of VIAF, because there's no notability criteria for VIAF besides it being in some library. Like, I found several family members in VIAF because they wrote a book, and I don't think they will ever get an item in Wikidata. So that's...
And vice versa, there are some very minor football players on Wikidata that I think that now the app is going to get. The big football players are already here. But
we have the question, the one.
I'm getting a bit tight on the time, so let's take this to the end. Otherwise, we'll run out of time. And talking about subsets, this is a simple diagram I made to show, for example, the creators of the Rijksmuseum. So A is the creators we have, so the painters in the Rijksmuseum. B is the references to Arcadi artists. Arcadi is actually in this building. It's the, I introduce yourself.
I'm Ben Beda. I'm an information specialist for Arcadi. I work mostly on the Thesauri, also the Dutch art and architecture translation.
Maybe you can explain what Arcadi art is.
Well, it's a set of biographical data structured in a database about mostly Dutch artists throughout the centuries, but also foreign artists if they have a connection to Dutch art in any way. And they are in our databases, the records for artists are linked to library archives and images and our other collection sets.
So, Yulan, I mentioned that before, that's the one from the Getty. So, but there's quite a bit of overlap, as you can see, between Arcadi artists and the Getty. This is based on what we have in Wikidata right now. And as you can see, the Rijksmuseum is almost complete with matching it to either one of them. I think I have 1,220 people already matched to both ULAN and RQD at the moment in Wikidata. So probably in a couple of weeks we'll be to 100%, assuming they're all in either of the databases. So that's, but there's still a lot of work, a lot of ground to cover. One of the tools used for that, it's called Mix and Match. It's about matching Wikidata items to items in external databases, for example, FIAF. And there you can see ULAN is also there, and RKD Art is also there. RKD is a bit more done than ULAN. This one is much bigger, that because your database only focuses on related to the Netherlands, and Getty is just much broader and bigger scope. So that tool, people use that, they get an interface where, okay, is this item on RKD the same as this item on Wikidata? If true, click yes, and otherwise, no.
I could also just go in there and make that decision.
Yeah. Anyone can look into that and play around with it. That's one of the tools we have. I'll mention some more tools a bit later. One of the other projects we're doing is it's called Sum of All Paintings. Of course, we have an item about Mona Lisa. It actually already existed in 97 languages, so it was there. But we, all, of course, have lots of paintings that aren't that big, aren't that important. For example, this painting, it's by Mesdag. It's probably, I think it's here in the Mauritshuis in one of the local museums. This item doesn't have an article on Wikipedia yet, but it does have an item on Wikidata. The goal of Sum of All Paintings is to get an item about every painting that is in the collection of a museum. To see.
RKD is worth also a little bit.
Yeah, we link to RKD images quite a lot. Not only the Mona Lisa, but get all the paintings in there. It's nice to bring together different collections. For example, this is a painting by Ludolf Backhuizen, and there are quite a few paintings about by him here in The Hague, but also quite a few of them in the Rijksmuseum in Amsterdam. Separate collections, but for us, they're all in the same system, so we can all see them together. This project is also nice for contemporary works because we only on Wikidata we only put metadata in there, so we don't have any copyright restrictions. So if the, for example, the MoMA or the Stedelijk Museum would decide to put metadata on Wikidata about all their works, about their Roy Lichtenstein's or whatever they have, that's no problem because it's only metadata. It's not the actual image of the painting. We can all we can store all of that. And of course, if you have all these different paintings by all these different artists in one location, you can create a catalogue raisonné for an artist. I know Jane did that for Frans Hals. Frans Hals is a Dutch painter. He was based out of Haarlem. And me and also Jane are both out of Haarlem. So we've been to the Frans Hals Museum plenty of times. So she made a catalogue raisonné of all the Frans Hals paintings according to, which source did you use again?
Seymour Slive, but I did about six other ones, depending on the biographer and the.
And that's all modeled in Wikidata. You can query that and you can look it up. And Frans Hals is quite complete, but we of course have lots of other painters we still would like to get complete. Like Rembrandt.
Go ahead. Well, actually, just a question. The catalog itself, has it ended up in Wikidata as well?
There's an item about the catalog, yes.
Curated, actually.
Yeah, but the only thing I'm using from the catalog is the actual number assigned to the painting. So the actual text describing the painting would be, that would be plagiarism, right? So, and that doesn't belong in Wikidata. All I have is a number assigned to a painting. So the number is associated with an actual ISBN number of the catalog code by the catalog creator. Okay. So in Frans Hals's case, the two definitive catalogs, according to the Frans Hals experts, is Seymour Slive, who died last year, and Klaus Grimm, a German guy, and they don't agree, of course, they don't agree. But, you know, all of those catalogs are up there, including catalogs that go back to 1883. Yeah. So I did all of them, but I only did four on Wikidata.
Yeah. Van Gogh, you also have like two major catalogs about it, and most of these records are also appearing in Wikidata right now. And we have a lot of tools, and they are scattered around there. It's like someone put over a toolbox to play around with. I'll highlight some of them. One is called AutoList or AutoList 2. There are two versions. A volunteer created a query engine, so you can query the Wikidata database saying, give me all the humans who were born in 1980, and it will return you a list. And based on that list, you can do all sorts of modifications. This is very powerful tool, but also very complicated to get the hang of. Once you get the hang of it, it has a bit of a learning curve. So what people do is they do these queries to find groups of items which still need some work, and then they can automatically edit from this tool. Some people did over a million items, a million edits using this tool to add statements. For example, this is a human, or this is a male, or this is a female. Those kind of tiny edits, but lots and lots of them. This is AutoList. It's based on a Wikidata query, it's called, and that breaks every once in a while, and then, so it's not that reliable as recently. We also have games. Games are all these things have in common that they ask you a simple question, like yes or no, or A or B. So for example, you have the gender game. You get an item, and the question is this a male or a female? And you answer it. And I already noticed some people playing it on their tablet on the starting talk. It's really fun to do and quite addictive. And it's very useful information. So is it the person, gender? Are these items the same? We have a lot of duplicate items that can just be merged into one. And the random game will just select one of the games. Beware, these can be very addictive. It's like you do your Sudoku maybe in the train, you can also play a game. Of course, this was all, yeah?
Can I just ask where that list is?
If you just Google Wikidata game, it will probably be the first hit. But maybe someone can put it in the Etherpad for this talk and do it later. So this is all about putting the data in, but of course you can get it out. We have an API, but this doesn't look for the developers amongst us. You can use this to get data out and to make things. But this is, of course, a bit scary. So this is one of the things that was built on top of it. It's called Resonator. This is a page that automatically generated based on the data that's in Wikidata. So he has an image. He has lots of links to external databases. Of course, his name in all different languages. He was a painter, when he was born, what kind of work, the sources describing him. And this is all generated from Wikidata. There's no manual editing. This is one of the toys I made a couple weeks ago. This is a family tree that gets generated on the fly based on the top item. So you can't read it probably. That's Louis XIV of France, the Sun King. And these are his ancestors, three generations. And it will just fetch this on the fly from Wikidata based on the API. It's just a really small tool. That data is all available. You just have to know how to get it out. Another tool is Krotos. I really like that one. It contains all the paintings or all the artworks we have in Wikidata and make it searchable. So I'm not sure what the query was on this one, but this is all the paintings we have in the Mauritshuis. And you can click on the links, for example, on Hans Memling, and then you get all the paintings by him. So it makes it easier to explore the different collections we have on Wikidata. And if we have a photo, it will show it. If it doesn't have a photo, it will just show a cross. Any questions?
That's a good one.
Any questions?
Yeah.
One quick specific one. So for each painter,
will have here many paintings.
Yes.
And then those paintings will also be items.
Yes.
Do you have to also go back the other way and say that each of the paintings was done by that painter?
So what you generally would do if you create an item for a painting, you would say the creator, so the painter, yeah, is some person. On an item about a person, for example, about Rembrandt, you would probably have notable works. There's an actual property called notable works, and you can use that to make a selection of works that are. It's a bit subjective which one to include, but you can make the links both directions.
Make a two-way link.
No, you don't have to, because it's in the database, so you can query it. Yeah, so in Reasonator, I didn't include that part. But if you open a painter and you scroll down, it will fetch items about paintings by that person.
Yeah.
And will show you the images.
You want it first?
Yeah, you beat him to it.
Okay. The point is, you presented some databases and some items, yeah, which are very well worked. You have good sources, that's the point. To use it in Wikipedia, different Wikipedias, is possible because you have a good source, you have a good references, and so on. But this is just a very, very small part of the items of Wikidata. How can you say this item is worse for using Wikipedia? Mm-hmm. How can you say this? And who will say this?
So we do have the concept of a featured item, I think, but that's that's why I included the photo of the desert, because some parts of the of our collection are really like a desert, no claims. I guess several subsets, for example, with some of our paintings, we have ways of doing queries to see, give me all the paintings in the Maurits house which doesn't have a creator, so you can start adding that. It's work in progress, but Wikipedia has always been work in progress, and it's not like.
I mean, I know the discussion in the German Wikipedia, and in general they all say no, we don't want to use Wikipedia. We want to use Wikidata in Wikipedia. That's a general idea right now.
So don't. You don't have to.
No. I think it's very important. I think it's very, very important that we use in future this, but we have to find a way to find quality in Wikidata.
So one thing that Wikipedias are doing is that Wikidata is used as a fallback. So if there's no local value set, it will fall back to Wikidata and look, hey, does Wikidata has a value for this? Say, for example, you have an info box and there's no image defined. It will just look on Wikidata, hey, maybe Wikidata has an image defined. Oh, that's the case, I'll just use that one. And that way you can slowly introduce it into your system. And
yes, but this won't work. Wikidata is growing all the time. It's growing much more in quantity as in quality. That's a problem too.
Just on that point. On that point, there's also templates that look and see what your local value is and compare that to the value on Wikidata and then throw up an error flag or a templated error if the two aren't the same, or a category, categorize it saying, this data doesn't match Wikidata. That way, if the mayor of some town you've never heard of changes, and that changes on Wikidata, at least it goes in a category on your local Wikipedia, on German Wikipedia, saying your data no longer matches Wikidata.
I think it offers great opportunities for inter-language collaboration, which, you know, we as the entire community can use more of. Since, you know, so many languages are in different silos, yet, you know, we're writing about the same topics just in different languages, and sharing underlying data is exceedingly important. And, you know, we on English Wikipedia have made small steps towards using Wikidata more, and we'll likely look at making more steps towards using Wikidata.
The main step on the English Wikipedia right now is the authority control, because it's already moved most of their stuff to Wikidata and already fetching it from Wikidata now. And that's slowly happening somewhere in the background. And it has to be baby steps.
Yeah.
we don't. We have plenty of time. I'm out of time. So if people want to leave, go ahead. That's last question, and then we'll.
We're just on that point. I was just saying, there's no reason why you can't automatically choose a group of sources or references that you consider to be notable enough, and automatically generate a list and restrict the data that you're using to things that are referenced in places that the community considers to be reputable enough. And also, because of all the external links to other sources, you could also automatically generate confidence scores to say when does this match enough with enough things on the web. So there's two ways you can automatically find out things that are more likely to be correct than others.
Thanks for your time. I'm out of time, so I'm still. Maybe I think there are drinks downstairs. Maybe that's a good place to discuss it.